Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I am going to work on this Blue Yeti microphone, which is my own Blue Yeti microphone I used to use for my videos. At the moment I am using another one what I repaired in a previous video. And the problem with this one is basically, as you can see, it's blinking, now it's plugged in. I already put a cable, so I removed the USB port from this one and I removed it, I replaced it with a USB cable, because the weakest point of this is the USB port itself. This will never fail again. The problem with this one is that it's being recognized by the computer, but only as a USB audio, as a general USB audio device, and in this way you have no way to set the parameters. In the Blue Yeti, it does not get recognized in the Blue Yeti software itself. You cannot update the firmware, and as I told, the sound quality, the recording quality is terrible. Basically, the way how it works is that there is an EEPROM inside this Blue Yeti, and all the settings are stored in this EEPROM, and the microcontroller or this target IC is reading all the settings from this EEPROM, and if it's getting corrupted, then this happens, that it's being recognized as a USB advanced audio device or something like this. I will show it to you later on. I already met with this problem 2 times before, and basically this was the microphone that I used to repair those microphones. So I already know, most probably know what is the problem with this one. So let me switch over to the settings, to the screen capture, and let me show you what is the problem with this one. So here we are in the settings, and as you can see, sorry, it's in Hungarian, but it means it's microphone. This is a 2 USB advanced audio device. So this is this faulty one. And this microphone number 3 Yeti stereo microphone is the one that I'm using at the moment for the stream itself, for the video itself. So it's not being recognized as a Blue Yeti or a Yeti stereo microphone like the other one. And basically why these Blue Yeti microphones are really great is that you do not need a driver for this. All these settings are stored all on the EEPROM, but due to some reasons, sometimes these EEPROM data are getting corrupted, and this is what you get. So it's being recognized as USB advanced audio device. And if I switch over to the Blue Yeti, Blue Sherpa software, here you can see that only one of them is showing up, and this is the one that I'm using for the video itself. There is not another additional Yeti here showing up, so it definitely does not work. So let me switch back to the camera and let's take it apart and let's find what is the problem. Okay, and then you can just pull it off. No, I will not be able to remove the case, because as you can see, I directly soldered the cable here to the relevant pads and I applied some hot glue and as a strain relief I put it here. And basically, most probably this is our issue here. This 8-pin IC is an EEPROM. And as I already told, I used the data from this one already to repair 2 additional Blue Yetis, and I already, luckily, I already stored the EEPROM, the firmware basically from this EEPROM on my computer, so most probably I can just reload it. So let me switch over to the microscope and we will remove this. So this is our EEPROM, and as you can see here we have a plastic potentiometer, or a potentiometer with some plastic parts in it. So we use a hot air nozzle basically to cover it up, and this way I am trying to save it from the heat, because I can tell you that I already killed some because I did not cover them up properly. And now I will use hot air to remove the EEPROM, just to memorize. This is pin number one, you can see here, it is our small dot. So as you can see, it came off pretty easily because I already used leaded solder to put it back. I will switch back now to the camera. Okay, so this is how I covered up the potentiometer, basically. And I use my plier as a bolt holder because there is also a potentiometer on the other side and there is this big head of the microphone, so there is no way to hold it properly. And the next thing I'm going to do is I will use my EZP 2019 Plus, which is a high-speed program. It's an EEPROM reader. It's good for the 24, 25 and 93 series EEPROMs. And I need to find the right socket for it. As you can see, I have multiple different versions, different sizes, all 8 pins, but one of them is slightly wider than the other one. I think I need to use this one. Yes. Okay, so you have to align it perfectly, and as you can see, this small copper leads are basically touching and grabbing the pins of the IC. And here you also have to make sure that pin number one should be on the top left, and then pin number one should be here at this position. So then you put this socket into this green socket, you tighten it up. Then you have to use a USB cable. Okay, and now I have to start the software of this ECP EEPROM reader. I will switch over to the window capture. Okay, so we open up the tool, the software of the programmer. And we will select the 24 EEPROM. It's a 24C02, so we will select that one, and then we click on read, and that's all. Basically our data is being read, so let's save it. I will also save this one, non-working on, to save. And then basically what we can do, I can open Hex Editor and compare a good and a bad reading, just to show you how it compares. So this is HXD program, and here you can select and analyze this data comparison and compare. And then you have to select the two data source. Non-working on is this is the wrong one that we just downloaded, and working from old version. This is the right one, and if I click on OK, then you can see that the right one is the OK, and the left one is the wrong one. And as you can see here, there are a few differences in the characters. The second part is absolutely OK, but the first part is not. So we will grab our working one, and we will upload it to our EEPROM. So we select working EEPROM file, so we open it, and then we will click on write, and write is complete. That's all. And now let's go back to the camera. Okay, so now we will remove it from the programmer. And let's solder it back. So I will switch back to the microscope. Okay, so it's nicely soldered on. Let's switch back to the camera. Okay, so now it's plugged in. LED is blinking. And let me switch over to the screen capture. And here you can see that now we have two Blue Yeti microphones. Let's see also in the Blue software. This is one of them, and this is the other one. So it works, and here I can also select the second Blue Yeti. So it works. Cool. So now it's muted, so you can see it's not moving here at all. And so now I will unmute it, and from now on you can see that I'm just knocking it, and it works. Let's mute it again, and now it does not work. It's muted. Okay guys, so that's it. Let's go back to the camera. And basically all what is left is putting it back to the frame carefully. Then as a final step, Let's put back all the buttons. This is the volume button goes here. And we are done. We have again a working Blue Yeti microphone. I have no idea why this corrupted firmware or corrupted EEPROM thing happens with all these. It's pretty annoying. And if you do not have a file like I do have, then you basically cannot repair it, because without the firmware, without the EEPROM data, it will not work. So if just Windows will recognize this as a standard USB advanced audio device, or however it's called, it will not work perfectly. You cannot use all the function of a Blue Yeti microphone, and it sounds terribly. So this is the only way to fix it. So okay guys, so that's all for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If yes, please don't forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel, and I hope I see you next time. Bye.